staff of Boxmoor State Secondary College. My name is Yo-Yo and this is Riley. Together we are your school ambassadors. We're both very privileged to be able to host our school assembly.
I'd like to begin our assembly by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land that we are gathered on today and recognise their continuing connection to the land and waters and community. I'd like to pay my respects to the elders, past, present and emerging, for they hold the memories, traditions, culture and hopes of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people across the nation. Could you please stand quietly for the Australian National Anthem?
Today we acknowledge the values of respect and responsibility. These values are when we show respect for the rights and responsibilities of our school community, allowing each of us to achieve our full potential. It is showing respect for ourselves and being sensitive and understanding to the needs of others.
This week we will show our respect for a number of groups of students within our school community that have shown a high level of responsibility throughout the school year. To begin our celebrations today, please welcome our school concert band conducted by Mr. Donnelly. They will perform for us today Procession of the Sidewalks by Mark Williams and Declaration by Gary Galazay.
Our values for this week are respect and responsibility. And it takes an incredible amount of responsibility to be able to perform that way. Their dedication at home and their dedication in the mornings is something to be very proud of, so thank you. Now, the values that we have this week are very important. They actually don't just show in our spirit values, they also form part of our three school rules. So if we are being respectful and we are being responsible, then we can be better learners. And learners we need in class, we also need from each other and in the world. So please be very respectful in the way that you treat each other, the way that you treat your teachers and your staff, and also the way that you treat your parents at home. Respect is a very important thing, and being responsible. It's not just remembering to pick up your hat and pick up your iPad. We do still collect a lot of hats. It's a lot more than that. It's being responsible for your own learning and always trying not to just be average. We don't want to settle for average here. We want to be more than that. So be a responsible learner, be a respectful person, and always be kind. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Mrs. Amon. Please stay on stage with us while we welcome Mrs. McLennan to the microphone.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm here to award some of our amazing Drama Festival students who worked incredibly hard over the past three terms, even without COVID, but have worked really hard, and they have an amazing competition that they saw happen in the school holidays. So yes, if Mrs. Amon would like to stand over here. Our Drama Festival competition has been running for 48 years, and it's a local drama competition that sees state schools, private schools and independent schools all compete doing full-length plays. So our students performed, some of you saw it, which was great, they performed for about 20 minutes in full length, and they learned all their lines and worked tirelessly and showed that real perseverance and that spirit of Foxwell. So, there was a group of 17 students, and we competed against 8 other schools in the junior section, which saw grade 7s and 8s, and we only had our beautiful grade 7s, so they did an incredible job competing against other year levels. So, can the following students, when I call your name, please come up and collect your certificate and a little gift that I have put together for you from Mrs. Amon. Laura Lightfoot.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Mrs. McLennan, and congratulations to all students involved in our very first Drama Festival entry. I would now like to welcome to the stage Mr. Anderson, Ms. Wells, and Ms. Wilson to celebrate the Girls Rugby League competition. I would like to invite Giovanni, Caitlin, Penatia, and Ophelia up to the stage. And I'd also like to invite any of the girls that came to play with us for the Rugby Nines.
In week two, 14 of us had the chance to represent the Boston Bruins at NRL Titans Girls Nines competition. We had such an amazing day working together as a team and playing our hearts.
Luckily, we only involved the way we were teaching and using the human beings. We all had so much fun, gaining friendships and jumping on our colleagues.
The girls would like to thank Ms. Wilson, Ms. Wells, and Ms. Anderson for helping to turn us on to our games. We learned from them to build them.
Could Kirby and Warren please stand up? Stand up. The team would like to thank you for tagging and being our head coaches and supporting us with our games.
After a hard year of having the opportunity to score, I'm very happy to be able to recognise some of the students that have been in the recent Rugby League Nines tournament, not only the girls but the boys as well. I'll call these students up in a second row and get some prize packs for them for their efforts. The students are going to perform as well, paraded up by our values during the tournament, not only respect and responsibility, but of service, perseverance, integrity, inclusivity, and teamwork throughout the competition, both on and off the field. So these students have been recognised by the coaches, so I'd like to personally thank Mr. Henry, Mr. Kimmer, Ms. Wells, and Ms. Wilson for their efforts as well. So for the boys, the two nominees and award winners were Kobe Carrera, who unfortunately can't be here today. We're going to give Kobe a round of applause.
Students to apply and let me know that they are interested will be the lucky recipients of the tickets to
along to the boat show. So if you are interested in that, jump into Cecil, not right now, later on. And the Friday activity that I sent you all today, there is a little video in there as well for you if you're keen to find out more about what you are signing up for. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Shepherd. What a great opportunity. Could I please invite Mrs. Ledbetter to tell us about the date for Daniel coming this Friday?
Hi everyone, and good afternoon, Ms. Simmons. Oh goodness, good afternoon, Ms. Ledbetter. Most of you call me Miss L, so good afternoon, Ms. Simmons.
Good afternoon, Miss L.
So what I'd like to talk to you about, you may have seen the notice on SharePoint or outside the Learning Hub. This Friday is Day for Daniel. Day for Daniel is Australia's largest day of action to raise awareness about child safety, child protection, and harm prevention. It's a really important day. It's held annually on the last Friday in October to honour Danny Morgan, who was abducted in 2003. So each year, schools and other organisations organise a walk for Daniel to remember him and to walk the 4 kilometres home that he was unable to make himself that day. We're actually going to be doing a slightly shorter walk this year, starting off. We're only going to be walking 1.4 kilometres and we'll be meeting Friday morning down at the Coomera foreshore at the, let me get the right name of the park, the Eagle Tree Park. We're going to meet there at 7:45 a.m. ready to leave at 7:50. So we'd really like for as many of you as possible to come and join the staff to wear red in support of the Daniel Morgan Foundation and walk as a group, as a community, to show our respect for Daniel, to remember him, but to also raise community awareness about this really important event. So, what do you need to remember? You need to remember to wear red on Friday. Red shirt, you still need to wear your full school uniform other than your red shirt. So we're not doing red hair, we're not doing red zinc, just a red shirt. Keep it nice and simple. Obviously, you need to have no inappropriate messages on your red shirt because that would be showing disrespect to what we're walking for. What else do you need to know? Second point. So, we're meeting at Eagle Tree Park at the Coomera foreshore at 7:45. Be prompt because we'll be leaving at 7:50. It will probably take us about 20 minutes to walk to school. Last thing. If you are walking and showing your support by wearing red, please bring a gold coin donation if you can, and the student leaders will be collecting this money. We will then donate all of the funds that we have raised to the Daniel Morgan Foundation. So get together as a team, Foxwell. Let's show our support for this really important day. Hope to see you all there.
Thank you, Ms. Ledbetter. This draws to a close today's assembly. Thank you to all students for your participation today. A reminder to all students that if a photo of you has appeared on today's assembly that you would prefer not to be included in our assembly broadcast, please see your deputy prior to Friday.
Your hand in.
Clap your